Welcome all. We the students of Vidyalankar Institute of Technology, Samreen Khan, Kadambari Prabhu and Priyanka Shetty are presenting a video on the topic Routing in AdHoc Networks under the guidance of Professor Saurabh Mehta Sir. The overview includes introduction, routing protocol classification, DSDV, DSR and ZRP routing protocol and finally comparing them. Routing simply means selecting a path. To route a packet from one end to other is a crucial task. Main goal of routing protocol is to devise a scheme to obtain optimal and efficient path between mobile nodes. It is not an easy task to determine which protocol is best suited for a network. Routing over ad hoc networks are broadly classified as topology-based and position-based approaches. Topology-based approaches use existing network links to collect information and perform packet forwarding, which can be further subdivided as proactive routing protocol or table-driven, which periodically updates routing table at each node to maintain consistent and up-to-date information. On the other hand, reactive routing or on-demand routing protocol employs a lazy approach where routes are created as and when required. Hybrid protocols combine local proactive and global reactive routing in order to achieve a higher level of efficiency and scalability. Finally, comes position-based routing protocol, which requires the physical information to determine the position of the destination node. It can be subdivided as greedy forwarding and restricted flooding. It overcomes some of the limitations of the topology-based routing protocol. Before moving ahead, let's see the classical distance vector routing. Let us consider there are four nodes in the network A, B, C and D, where distance between them is 1. Every node in the network sends hello packet to its adjacent node and maintains and updates their own routing table. A will update its table as B is equal to 1, C is equal to infinity and D is equal to infinity. Accordingly, B will update as A is equal to 1, C is equal to 1 and D is equal to infinity, and others will update accordingly. After broadcasting, this is the final scenario of the network. Now, we look on to count to infinity problem. Somehow, link between C and D is broken, then C will update its entry in the table as D is equal to infinity. This problem arises when A broadcasts its table to C before C can broadcast it. Entry of D in A is equal to 2. When A broadcasts table to C, it will update the entry of D to 3. Since C to A is 1 and D to A is 2, so total is 3. As C has no information that A is calculating its distance via C. Now, C broadcast this table to A and again updates its entry to D to 4. That is, A to C is 1, C to D is 3. Total is 4. This goes up to infinity. This problem can be resolved using DSDV routing protocol. Now, DSDV routing protocol. This protocol comes up with a destination sequence number added with every routing entry, and this sequence number increases by 2 on each advertisement and by 1 if adjacent node is no more reachable. As updated information is received, then only nodes will update their respective routing table. The format of routing table's entry is as destination number, next hop, distance, sequence number. Here, each node contains information regarding all known destinations. Now, consider three nodes, A, B and C. After broadcasting routing table by each node, this will be the final scenario of the network. If D comes in picture with sequence number D00 and broadcast its table to C, so accordingly, C will update this information in its table and also increase its sequence number from C20 to C22 and then broadcast this to B. A similar pattern will be followed for node B and then B can broadcast to A. We will see how the count to infinity problem can be resolved using DSDV routing protocol. consider somehow link between C and D is broken. So C updates the distance of D as infinity and sequence number from D 00 to D 01, that is, it increases by 1 in its routing table. As we can see, now there is no more count to infinity problem because B broadcasted table to C. C will not update the entry of D since it already has updated information about D. So B will update its own table according to C. Next is DSR, Dynamic Source Routing Protocol. This one is a reactive protocol which consists of two major phases, route discovery and route maintenance. Route discovery is initiated by sending route request packet whose format includes unique ID, list of nodes, that is intermediate nodes, source and destination. Then route reply packet is generated by destination. Now consider this network where the objective is to deliver the data from S to D. S will generate route request packet and broadcast it. Then respective nodes receive the packet and checks whether it has a route to destination. If it doesn't, then it adds its own address to the route record and forwards the packet. Looking ahead, A, B and C has no information regarding D, so they will add their own address in the route request packet and then broadcast the packet. So A will broadcast S. Since S already has the same packet, it will discard it. If we look ahead, C broadcasts it to G, B and S, from which S and B both will again discard the packet since they already have it. Now, if B broadcast, it will send the packet to S, C, J and F, from which S and C will discard it, while J and F checks the route to D. So they will add their own address, J and F, to the packet and broadcast it. Coming to F, F broadcast to D, E and H. This way, route request packet reaches to destination D. Now, D will generate route reply packet using intermediate nodes in a reverse manner to reach the source S. Let's see route maintenance in DSR. If link between B and F is broken, B will broadcast this using route error packet and it will remove this route from the cache memory and search for another route via J, E, F to D. Let's see the zone routing protocol, which is a hybrid routing protocol designed to speed up delivery and reduce processing overhead. It uses best part of proactive and reactive routing protocols. The parameters this considers is zone radius, peripheral node, intra-zone routing protocol and inter-zone routing protocol. We will get familiar with these parameters through an example. Let's consider a network where A is at the center of the zone with zone radius 2. B and C are at distance 1, where D, E and F are at a distance of 2 from A, also called as peripheral nodes. Within the zone, it uses proactive and outside, it uses reactive routing protocol. Let's see how ZRP works. The objective is to deliver data from A to L. A will create its own zone and forward data using D, F and G, which are its peripheral nodes. For G, it will again create its zone and forward data using A, E, M and F, which are its peripheral nodes. This process continues until it reaches the destination L. As we have seen all the protocols, let's compare them now. Firstly, route information is available always in proactive routing, whereas not in reactive routing, and it is available in the zone and hybrid. Route discovery is not required in routing protocol, which is proactive, because the information is already available in the table. Comparing the reactive routing protocol, the route discovery is on demand as and when required. In hybrid, it is not required in the zone, while on demand outside the zone. Delay for route discovery is less in reactive, more in proactive, whereas in hybrid, in the zone delay is less, whereas outside is more. Multiple paths are available in proactive routing protocol and not in reactive. Energy consumption is more in proactive routing protocol and less in reactive. In the zone, hybrid in the zone less, whereas more out of the zone in hybrid. These are the references. Thanks for watching.